Pure FM, l'esprit des festivals, en quarter. Pure.
Hello London Grammar.
Hello. Salut.
Welcome, merci d'être avec nous. Vous parlez un peu français?
Je parle un petit peu, oui.
Ah.
Sans accent?
En plus
Bravo.
Très bon.
In several interviews, you said that you absolutely did not consider yourselves as rock stars. But when you're in a festival where there are a lot of rock stars, do you feel you're like the only ones of your kind? You know, stuck between like Metallica today and, you know.
I don't know, there's kind of, I suppose we have more of these guys we see around who are probably more in line with us. Like, we see, they're even probably more pop than us, the ones that we sort of hang out with. But we see a lot like John Newman and I guess Disclosure, I guess Bastille, people like that. Just kind of English, slightly poppier acts.
We're kind of in the middle, you know. We're just not particularly rock and roll. He says with his sunglasses on.
Yeah. On n'est pas très rock and roll, mais il a quand même gardé ses lunettes noires pour l'interview. That's a rock star thing.
I know. That's why I realized I should take them off.
C'est pour ça qu'il les a enlevés.
But it was unintentional. But no, you know, it's cool, and everyone always treats us like. You know, we are a rock band, kind of, so that's okay then. Yeah.
You have a very precise sound and a way of putting the voice up front. Is it difficult when you're, you know, touring the festivals? Because sometimes sound checks last for 5 minutes and a half, and your sound's so precise. So is it hard for you, or is it doable?
I mean, yeah, normally we don't ever have a sound check at the festivals, so it's...
We don't really sound check that much anyway.
It's difficult because when you're doing your own shows, you don't have to really because you're touring all your own gear and stuff. Whereas at festivals, sometimes you're just thrown in. But people, I think that's the difference with the festivals. When you play your own headline show, there's a lot more pressure because people are there, they've paid tickets just to see you. And whereas when you go to a festival, it's kind of, there's always problems. Everyone has technical problems. You see a band, I mean, 9 times out of 10 at any festival, they won't come off stage and say they didn't have any issues. So people just kind of, that's kind of part of it, and everyone's kind of in it together, and it's okay. So sometimes we go to a country and don't actually know which song was the most popular song.
In
Switzerland, we didn't know.
I was saying today that we weren't sure how, we never know quite how big we are in certain places. You don't really know what to expect. So, you know, when we played in Norway, when did we play in Norway? Yesterday?
Two days ago.
Sorry, I forget.
How very rock star.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, and we weren't, you know, the crowd wasn't so big, but I know that in, you know, having searched it, now I know that in Belgium, I know that, you know, Strong and Wasting My Young Years sort of were top 10 hits here. So I guess it changes everywhere you go. But obviously stuff like The Voice, and you know, mainstream programs like that in these countries help massively.
Ils sont super pressés, nos amis London Grammar. Je vois, on a le temps de leur dire merci.
Merci beaucoup d'être passé nous voir, London merci. Grammar, avec merci. Un album qui s'appelle If You Wait. Et le groupe sera de retour en Belgique, ce sera le 9 septembre à Forêt Nationale. Merci beaucoup.
Merci. Merci beaucoup.
À bientôt.
Pure FM, l'esprit des festivals, en quarter. Pure.